Well, this is James Hundley. I'm with Romario, and we're talking about setting up rest stroke on the right hand. This is going to be an important video because the question always is, what is our position of the knuckles or the hand in rest stroke? At a free stroke position, we're going to lift forward. Let's go to free stroke. The proximal joint, middle joint here, the proximal joint is going to be in front of the string, allowing the motion to be an upward motion with a flex of the distal interphalangeal joint there. Can you play some free stroke for me? Right. Okay, let's go to rest stroke. So take a look at, let's look at what's going on with the hand. I'm going to show you on the inside of the hand. The metacarpal is pretty high. There's a nice C shape into the hand. And the proximal joint, the middle joint, is over the string. He's touching the string on the flesh by the fingernail. For rest stroke, we're going to bring the metacarpal back. And the proximal joint is going to line up. And we always line up the middle finger first. So let's tuck this in for a second so you can see that middle finger. We want to work on that middle finger. So the idea is that the metacarpal main knuckle pushes the finger down. The travel down identifies the string. You feel and touch the string on the tip of the finger. And then you fire forward into the string. As you notice, when you fire forward through the string, you have resistance. So this resistance has to find an optimal place. You have to minimize it by using its optimal position. By doing that, and everybody's going to be slightly different, we take the proximal joint, which is now at about 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock and on a circular clock, bring the proximal joint behind. Everybody's going to be slightly different from this. That way, when the proximal joint, can you do a rest stroke there? When the proximal joint travels through the string, the distal bends, the recovery is a lift from the proximal joint. So let's do it with the index finger for a second. Okay, so when the eye is touching the string, here's eye touching the string, the proximal joint is going to be slightly almost behind the third string for him, and he's going to go ahead and play through that and rest on the string, go ahead, play, and then lift. So what we're trying to do is stabilize the main knuckle, the metacarpal, so that it doesn't move, and the distance between the metacarpal and the tip of the finger stays constant. The travel is here, touch, fire, proximal lift, touch, fire, and then a proximal lift. Want to try that again? Touch, fire, and lift. This circular motion is universally called an orbit, but typically we set up the middle joint, or the middle finger, sorry, first because it's the longest finger. So we have to make sure that the middle finger travels with comfort into the end of the hand without rocking this joint, which is the metacarpal. All right, that's the setup for right now of rest stroke